is, bitch. I am healthy, I am wealthy, I am rich, I am that bitch. I am gonna go get that bag and I am not gonna take your shit. I am protected, well respected, I'm a queen, I'm a dream. I do what I wanna do and I'm who I wanna be. Cause I am.
Hello, universe. I know I don't ask for much, but I really could use some guidance. Do you think you could send me a familiar? Any kind. Any kind will do. A monkey? Cat? I'll take what I can get. Thank you.
Hello. I am a symbol from the universe, and I came to-
You an ant! Oh!
What the fuck is that fucking thing?
What the fuck?
Hello?
What?
What?
Chill.
Scary.
Yo, I'ma check his vibe.
What are you?
Yeah, what are you?
Bad vibe!
My heart's been pierced by Cupid. I disdain all glittering gold. There is nothing can console me but my jolly sailor bold.
Would I be upset if a cute witch turned me into a raven so I could be her familiar? No, I wouldn't be upset at all. I would get to collect shiny things and herbs and flowers with her, and it would be very fun.
There's no way that's a fucking turd.
Yeah.
This Sun Fox is the 11th in my series of witches familiars. Folk stories say the Sun Foxes originated from the sun's teardrops that fell into consciousness on their way down to Earth. Whether or not this is true, Sun Foxes have unusually high body temperatures, making them ideal companions for those who live in cold climates or have circulatory issues. They also have adorable sneezes, making them ideal companions for just about everyone. Highly energetic, a sun fox will need plenty of room to roam and explore, perhaps looking for their way back to the sun, but will always return home to you. If you decide to explore alongside your sun fox, you'll find they have an excellent sense of direction and a keen nose for adventure. And for snacks.
If this abandoned tarot card building does not scream witchcraft, I don't know what does. It's literally covered in birds that won't leave no matter how close you get to them.
This crow is the 7th in my series of witches' familiars. With a keen eye in mind, this is the perfect companion for anyone with memory problems or just a lot on their plate. They're extremely helpful in gathering hard-to-find ingredients for potions, spells, and old secret family recipes. They'll also bring you the occasional worm because Crow loves worm, so you will love worm too, right? In addition to being able to remember long lists of ingredients, they'll remember whether or not you've taken your medication today and help you remember too. In the event that you find yourself lost deep in the woods while collecting mushrooms and the sun is setting and it's getting colder and the bears are coming out to snack, your crow familiar will come find you and lead you safely home.
Today, I'm going to give you some tips for befriending your local crows or other corvid species. This relationship can be very special if you stick to it for a few months. Yes, they bring you shiny things. Yes, you will be able to pet them. But here are some tips that you really have to be consistent with. One, make sure you bring them good treats that are nutritious. Just look up online for corvid-friendly treats. Two, make sure you set up a schedule. come the same day, the same time, and they'll start anticipating you. 3, mirror their movements. Do not chase after them or pursue them. You will scare them away. But eventually, you should be able to get up close and personal with any wild animal. Now remember, I used rice cake and wash those hands!
5, 6, 7, 8. Dance with me in my backyard, boy. Looking super fine in your corduroy. Drive me round the block, we can go in a loop. And we'll turn the volume up on some good boy band tunes. I feel the fresh air, I can feel your eyes staring. I'm not gonna lie.
So I'm hanging out on the couch, my floors are super dirty, and I just realize, yes, there's a stain, but what is that?
Yes, there's also a bunch of flowers on the floor because witchcraft, but I was just asking my cat if she had any extra whiskers, and she pulled through.
This is my familiar, Palette. I had her for 19 years. She passed away 6 years ago. Her birthday was Halloween. This is a Samhain altar dedicated to her. Very similar to an ancestor altar. I included her ashes, her photo, and some of her favorite things. She may not be with me in physical form, but she's always with me in my heart.
This Luna moth is the 6th in my series of witches' familiars. Their wings will always reflect the current phase of the moon, and they are excellent little timekeepers, much more reliable than a watch or phone. On rainy nights, they like to stay indoors and snuggle close, particularly if you have long hair they can nest in. Sometimes, when the stars are very bright and the moon is very full, they enjoy a small droplet of white wine and will sing sad songs to the moon. Otherwise, they tend to enjoy late nights, hot cups of coffee, and the occasional true crime podcast, and are excellent companions for mystery seekers. The 4th in my series of witches' familiars is a little slug wearing a crown. They look like a regular slug, just a little more glamorous. Their ooze makes an excellent healing ointment for burns, cuts, scrapes, and other injuries. Sometimes it also forms interesting and beautiful designs. These tend to make everyone around them just a little bit happier. Other than that, they're not good for a whole lot magically, but they're real sweeties and will love you with the whole of their little slug hearts.
Hey friends, I'm outside building my fort and Tesla right here. Tesla. Yeah, Tesla. She brought me this. Look at this. It's part of a buck. I wonder if she's the culprit who brought the other skull.